keyboards.
Kick it live, come on. That's why I bibbit the bibbit the bit, boom boom, bibbit the slaps the hand. The bibbit the bit, boom boom, the jam, the bibbit the bit, the bit, boom jam this.
It is January 1995. Lyricist Tariq Trotter and co-managers Richard Nichols and Joe Simmons have just received a script for the music video, which they are scheduled to shoot in a week. The video is for the song Silent Treatment. Already there are concerns.
I didn't talk to her again. Did you see Frank's treatment?
Nah.
They faxed it here.
Yeah, I
like it. Amir saw the shit and just never gave it. Amir never gave it to anybody.
Because
I didn't know that he had even sent one. I knew he had talked to the dude, but I didn't know they had sent one.
What does this have to do with a girl? This has nothing to do with child treatment.
The Roots have just finished recording their first album for Geffen, Do You Want More? But there's still work to do. They are now working on a series of remixes of the tunes to create alternate versions, including artistic revisions, cleaner versions for radio stations, and longer versions for dance clubs. The album will be released in a week. They will embark on a two-week tour of both coasts. They'll appear on a Jon Stewart TV show, have several live dates, shoot a music video, meet the Los Angeles staff of Geffen, and generally hope to make their mark on the West Coast. Many people in the hip-hop world were surprised by this pairing, surprised that Geffen would go into hip-hop at all, and surprised that the Roots would choose a company which lacked any real street credibility so important to success in this world. Having signed their contract over a year ago, the next few weeks will be a critical time. Each of the band members will begin to see if years of hard work will pay off. Also, the relationship between the group and the record company will be tested.
Yo, is there like an ice cold chance in hell that could be up here for this mixing session? For the dropouts.
Tomorrow?
Yes. It's almost imperative.
Drummer Amir Thompson is talking with Geffen's Jennifer Carlson.
I mean, I can even.
He wants to stay in New York one extra night to supervise a remix.
You can stay tonight, but I don't think the hotel. We can have to keep an extra night.
And you don't think I could? I mean, even for New Jersey Transit. I think it's round trip like 15.
It'd make more sense for you to stay tonight. Find a place to stay tonight and then leave tomorrow night. It's not going to cost anybody extra money if you can find a place to crash tonight, is what I'm saying. I'm going to be in the studio tonight, so.
I know no one in New York.
What about Amy?
She can't let me crash at a crib. Okay, what's the number? Hello? Hi. Question. Yeah, well, instead of avoiding a $16 train charge to come back up here tomorrow to mix, she's having us do the rounds and calling people to see whose floor we can occupy tonight. Well, not we. Me.
Well, Amir does not get the money he needs to either stay overnight in New York or return the next day to supervise the mix.
Come on, why are you cursing at me? I'm just the artist.
Several days later, the first tour stop is right at home in Philadelphia. A live appearance at the downtown Tower Record Store. Tariq is waiting for the rest of the band to show. Geffen A&R person Wendy Goldstein has driven in from New York where the band had just been taped for the late night Jon Stewart TV show.
What's up?
How are you, sweetie?
Come on.
Okay.
Cool.
All right. How's everyone else? How'd it go last night?
A
little hectic at Hot 97, I heard.
Oh, yeah, man. I 97.
You enjoy yourself last night? On the TV show?
Oh, yeah.
John Stewart to me.
See, there's so much shit that happened since in between that John Stewart show and now.
That you forgot about it.
I mean, it seemed like it wasn't last night. You know
he came up, the good news is, he came up to me and he was like, they were fucking brilliant.
Word.
He really dug it a lot.
Wendy Goldstein was responsible for signing the group.
I heard about the Roots that first week I was at Geffen Records. A guy by the name of Derek Jackson and a woman by the name of Francesca Spiro, who I'm very tight with, came up to have a meeting for me. They manage a lot of producers, and they said, you have to hear the group The Roots. They are amazing. And I was totally open. I hadn't signed any group to Geffen yet. I was here a week. So they told me about this great group, The Roots, and I had to go to Philly that weekend, they told me, to see them. Because there were all these labels interested, and we had to go that weekend, and I was like, okay, I'm there. And I saw them in this little floppy rehearsal room in Germantown in Philadelphia, up over a second floor of a storefront, and they just blew me away. I just thought that there was such talent there, and they were on to something that was just so unique and so different, and that for Geffen getting into a new genre of music, what a better way to start it than do it with something that was totally artistic, totally musical, incredible, had all the dynamics that people really haven't seen before, that to just really strike it off and start it off with something totally, totally different.
Stab it out. Go home, get some sleep before you get on that road.
Ain't no sleep. No sleep.
Like, you got to go straight to
the studio.
Got
to leave here, go home, pack and shit, and take a shower, and then go to the studio, then go to D.C.
Okay,
we're going to be down in D.C. for 2 days. We leave D.C., we're going to New York on Monday, then we leave New York and go to Cali. Cali and go to France. You know what I'm saying? It's like, yeah. Shit is wild.
You tired.
Yeah. And then we're going to be overseas for another month.
From the top of the dome, monumental. Is it coincidental over instrumental? Sir, I proceed to give you what you need. Black Lord, I got the flame indeed. Now we like to welcome everybody in the house that has felt some love for the people representing from the city of the brotherly. Love is the Mr. Black Lord, no one can cover me. More rise above us the way I maintain.
Co-founder Amir Thompson has been performing since he was a child. He joined his father's doo-wop group, Lee Andrews and the Hearts, and by the time he was 12, he had become their music director.
Back in 75, my parents didn't believe in babysitters, so they figured they'd just watch me on stage. I mean, my father went from oldies doo-wop legend in Philadelphia to a solo act in the 60s, and because he had a very good nightclub act, top of the line. That's where I get a lot of my inspiration up.